pictures of the smiles we left behind. Smiles we gave to one another for the way we were.
Yeah, when I got up this morning, I looked online and saw that it was only 900 CFS in the river, and I thought, well, it's, the forecast is going to come true. It's going to get up to 1,500. I got up the access road, got a call from Faraday Control, and they told me it's up to 1,900 CFS. I quickly drove down in here and saw that the bridge had been compromised with the bridge abutment, and got a hold of McDougall, and he mobilized. And it took time because the river was coming up and we had to get things out of the way. One thing that was good about today, with the time that we took to get the wells out, the biologists were able to salvage over 200 fish out of the trap area down below before we breached the cofferdam. It was interesting when they started pulling the pumps, we started seeing a little bit of bleed through. And then as they pulled more and more pumps, we started to see more and more of the water come through the cofferdam, start to slough off. Started to get concerned about that. It was a little exciting there when we started digging the notch and saw material slough away from us and backed off and then went back out there and continued to dig the notch. So it was a pretty exciting day today. And then once it started going, it just started ripping, tearing that sediment out and taking it downstream for us. It did surprise me how fast it started to knock back. I thought it'd be a little more gradual, but this river's got power. It's been an amazing day. People have worked many, many months and years on trying to figure out exactly how this would happen. And to finally see it come to pass, I think it just gives everybody a great sense of satisfaction.
Between the pages of my mind, memories sweetened through the ages just like wine. Silent thoughts come floating down and settle softly to the ground like golden.
lollipops and red bouquets and twilight's trimmed